we are freedom fighters, and we believe in freedom of speech. So we may not agree with what you believe in or what you have to say, but we appreciate the fact that you come to Canada and you have those rights.
Come to Canada? I was born at York Finch General Hospital in Toronto, Ontario, Canada. My father's from Newfoundland. My mother's from Jamaica. My mom was like a prettier version of Oprah Winfrey. Like, I'm serious. I was a lot more...
It's like a Frenchman saying, "Ta barnak."
Disrespectful when I would talk to Muslims before. Yeah. Until again, somebody said to me, which I'm going to ask you, can you tell me one knowledge, anything? The guy walking away, the guy here, looking for more people to talk to. Please tell me one thing, one verse. Tell me one thing in Islam. One verse.
Well, I've never studied it.
This is to everybody watching this video. Please give me one verse.
By the Jews.
One verse, man.
Listen,
hey, can you listen to this? Can you please give me one verse, a direct quote? You guys have all this. Listen to me. I know what this means. I'm asking you. Listen, look at me. Look at me. Look at me. Look at me. I'm asking you. Give me one verse in the Quran or the authentic hadith. One word. Since you're saying you have knowledge, give me one verse.
Surah 8:12.
Give me one verse. Repeat it in Arabic too.
What do you mean?
Oh yeah. Fuck.
Because you're giving me a transliteration. You're giving me a translation which is open to interpretation. Please give me one verse in Arabic in the Quran. And then we'll continue this.
Well, we don't speak Arabic.
One verse, man. So, I don't speak Arabic, but I learned it.
Yeah. I'm not from Arabic country. I'm from English country.
Yeah.
Right? There's Muslim all over the world.
Oh yeah, we know that.
Right?
Yeah.
Right. So when a guy last name is Arabic, and he's Muslim,
yeah,
and he's a mental fuck that goes crazy and kills somebody. Yeah. It's not the religion. It's that guy, just like a Christian guy, John Smith.
So again, since you're very vocal, please tell me one verse, man.
Got nothing to do with
Christian. In Arabic, please, because you clearly have no knowledge, man. The only knowledge you have is it says infidel. You know it says infidel kafir on your neck. That's all you know. That's all you know, man.
Okay, then you look at us.
Yo, bro, I'm telling you.
What did they say about us?
I'm telling you. It just means disbelief. That's all it means. So I'm telling you, if you want to come here,
what does it say in the Quran?
Please, I am going to continue this conversation if you can show me you have one bit of knowledge.
But tell me what you're supposed to do to the dog believer.
What does it say? What is supposed to live in peace and harmony every single person?
But what if there's a non-believer, though?
Listen to me. Even if you go back, way back when there was an empire, the Islamic empire, the Caliphate, even way back, Christians and Jews live with them. He don't want to hear it, man. You guys aren't here to gain knowledge.
But you still didn't answer my question.
I know, but nobody's listening.
I'm listening to the answer.
You have the camera on me, expecting me to answer to the camera. And then you're going to distort the words.
It's live. I ain't going to distort
this
nothing.
This is fine, but why aren't these guys listening? If you guys are here to gain knowledge, if you want to know your enemy, you call us your enemy, study it. I hope this is live. I believe it's live. Study the religion. The Marines do it. The Navy SEALs do it. You think this is your enemy, study it. Don't just come wearing a kafir hat.
One guy wants to know, what about underage marriages?
When you sit in your grave, you'll find out.
Again. Underage marriages. If you want to talk about that in Islam, please, who's watching this, type up anywhere on Google underage marriages in the United States currently, right now, and the states that allow it. Do that.
New York State.
Do that. Do that.
New York State just.
Okay, so if you're going to come to me and ask this question, ask yourself the same question. Ask the millions of people, ask them the same question. We can play ping pong all day. We can play ping pong all day. But how do you know what a pattern is if you don't know any knowledge? You're not even telling me anything in Islam. You can't say there's a pattern if you don't even know any knowledge. Like, come on, man. I used to be a non-Muslim who accepted Islam.
I believe the same thing.
I gained the knowledge.
You can't believe I said that.
How about you read it to me?
You think we're worshiping those guys?
How about you read it to me?
Those guys are...
I don't read noodle. I speak English, and the English language is composed of 200 different languages all in one.
Just because the name.
So again, you see, you're telling me I'm being, like, we're kind of like, what, disrespectful? We're the enemy. You're clearly coming with a hostile nature. You don't speak noodle? What does noodle mean?
Muslims over here.
What does noodle mean?
Over there.
If you want to talk about the authenticity of language, it's a lot more.
Want to kill each other.
There's a lot more to Arabic than English, man. I'll tell you that.
So what made you convert?
Me, personally?
Yeah.
Would you like to face the kid good?
Yeah.
What made me accept Islam? Okay?
Yes.
I went to university. I played hockey. I was drafted to the Barry Colts in the OHL. Yeah, I played hockey. I was doing very good in my life.
That's pretty much an
I had a friend.
Muslim caliphate.
You want to like talk words? There's not so many people talking.
Yeah. I go here a bit more.
The way that I accepted Islam is I had a friend who used to talk to me about Islam, and I used to debate him with Christianity.
Okay.
His friend, like his brother, I mean, sorry, like his actual blood brother, he was doing things in his life he shouldn't be doing, but then he accepted Islam.
Yeah.
Okay. Like he started practicing his religion, I should say.
Right.
So then what I did was I'm debating back and forth, back and forth, back and forth.
Yeah.
Until actually one day, 1 second, brother, I'm almost done. Until one day, literally, when he said, he's like, have you read anything?
Yeah.
So I said, no, I was honest. So then I started reading. The debating stopped from debating to me actually reading, because I'm thinking, okay, if I gain knowledge, I'm going to come at them in a way where I can hit them with things, not like how you guys coming at me like this. I'm going to hit them with knowledge.
Yeah.
But it stopped from debating.
No, so see, that's what I told you in the beginning. I'm coming with minimal knowledge.
You are, not them. You should have different people around you, man. If you want to make an impact... If you want to make an impact, don't come wearing like kaffir stuff, like the word kaffir everywhere. That's because, listen to me, that's fine. In this country, you can wear that.
What does it mean to you?
Nobody's disrespecting that. All I'm saying is if you're coming, like you're saying, under the guise of gaining knowledge, come on, man. Come on, man. Come on.
What does this mean to you, though?
The Navy SEALs even go and they blend in. They know the language. They know the religion.
Yeah, but we're not hiding.
Nobody's hiding, man.
Yeah, we're not here to Islam, brother.
Nobody's hiding. You understand what I'm saying? Don't worry, I'm going to come back.
Okay, all right.